Hi, I'm Debbie Cortez. I am a graduate of UHD as of December 2015 with a criminal justice degree. And initially, I transferred over from St. Thomas University. And I chose UHD because they're the only ones at that time that had a criminal justice degree plan. I am not your traditional college student. I am obviously over 25, and I wasn't sure how to fit in here. My first experience was with Dr. Kavanaugh, because it was an online course, and I had never met him. So I scheduled the course, and I bought the book, and then he let me know they'd given you the wrong book. So I didn't know what to do because I was going to be online. I was going to have surgery. I didn't have time to change this book. He called me in and he said, come and make copies of my book. I'll let you use my book. That made an impression on me because I thought, oh, if all the professors are like this, this is going to be wonderful. So I started at UHD. I was more concerned about my courses initially because it had been quite a while since I'd done college or been in a college. I only took 3 courses per semester because that was the maximum I thought I could handle. In my first 3 courses, one of the professors was Dr. Keller. Dr. Keller made such an impression on me because he was an older gentleman. He just sat and talked to us, and I thought, if he could do this and get a doctorate, then I could do this. My courses were always 3 at a time, but I found that every professor that I had in the criminal justice area, they always worked with me. They always made sure that I wasn't stressed out. I could talk to them. I always, and I recommend this to everyone, make an appointment with a professor, meet them face to face before your courses start, and they will work with you. Every professor has done that with me. Every professor has encouraged me. All of them, Dr. Carson told me, do the study abroad, you will get such a delight in doing that. And of course I went, and I loved it because we went to London and we saw the criminal justice course there. I'm sorry, the criminal justice area in London. After a while, I had heard about APS, and I thought, I wonder what this is, and I got an invitation from Dr. Kavanaugh to apply for it. And so I did. I didn't know if I had the grades for it or not, but because of my age and I wanted to make an impression on any future employer, I wanted to be sure I made the dean's list. So after my second semester here at UHD, that was what my goal was, every semester to make the dean's list. I applied, I got into APS, which is the honors organization for criminal justice, and I fell in love with the people because they were wonderful. Dr. Kavanaugh was our advisor. He was so laid back, he allowed us to make decisions. He allowed us to advise him, and by the second year with APS, I actually became a secretary on board, and that's what I continued to do for them because I wanted to be involved. It whet my appetite for being in organizations here at UHD. I found that as I progressed through, even my advisor, Mrs. Sparta, would say, Debbie, this is the courses you need to take. Be sure you do this. And I never had a problem. I always knew exactly where I was going. I knew what courses I needed to take. I knew where I had to go as far as graduating by December. That was my goal, graduate by December 2015. I had one little blurb. I needed to take courses in one area. And I already had some philosophy courses, so I chose to do philosophy. When I got into my junior year in philosophy, those were upper level philosophy courses. There was only 5 others in that course. I was lost. So I went to Mrs. Barsa. She said, go and talk to Dr. Davis, transfer into sociology. And this was like a week before the semester was supposed to start. And she did it. She let me into these courses, into her course. I got in, and so that was what I chose to do afterwards. Toward the end, my senior year, I remember I was getting very nostalgic because I knew it was coming to an end. I love my life here. Dr. Van Horn, who is the dean, I worked several times at events that were held here at UHD. I always volunteered to be one of the speakers for orientation for the freshmen. And she always encouraged me. She always said, you can do this and don't give up. And all of my professors were saying, graduate and try to think about going further because you will be able to do this. Go for your master's eventually. So it is still on the back of my mind. I did graduate December 2015. I was part of that enormous class. Not only did I graduate, but I graduated summa cum laude, which I didn't think I was going to be able to do. And when I heard that there was only 39 of us, I think, at that time, I was just amazed. I still miss my life here at UHD. I'm still thinking, oh, I would be doing this, or I would be doing that, or I would be in one main, or I would be in commerce, or I would be seeing these professors. But I know that I have to move on. I want to stay in the criminal justice field. I want to be a victim's advocate, either in the court system or with the DA. And that is still my goal. I still haven't found the job that I really want, but I know it's going to happen because I'm prepared. UHD prepared me. And I encourage students to think about this campus. It is small, it's intimate. The professors will get to know you. And if you meet the dean, she will encourage you and she will work with you. I think all the deans would do that.